If he doesn't want to lick my underarm hair, then I'm a woman. Drop the camera. Okay, here we go. Oh, don't. Oh! Oops. I need to go get that. Cheers. This avocado is still a little hard, not quite ripe, so I'm gonna have to really mash this pork in here. Yeah, to be able to eat it. Still very good though, even without the tomatoes. This is one of my favorite things to have for breakfast. And oh, fell on my robe, so this is one of my favorite things to have for breakfast because number one, I love pico de gallo, so putting that on top of the avocado is pretty much like having guac. But also putting cayenne and having a little spice in the morning is one of my favorites because I've always loved spicy foods. I would eat hot Cheetos all the time when I wasn't vegan, but I haven't had hot Cheetos in a very long time, and when I crave something spicy, I just put some cayenne on whatever I'm eating and it cures my craving. So good. That fell on the floor. But I still ate it. Okay, this is gonna be tricky. I'm not eating that. I'm gonna leave it in the fridge to get ripe. Grabbed some strawberries instead. Oh, so cute. And these strawberries are so, so good. Mm. You know when you get sour, when you get strawberries that are sour? These aren't sour at all. They're so, so sweet. Ziki's playing with his mouse. I was just thinking, and it's interesting because one of the things I've noticed where my anxiety will arise is sometimes when I'm talking on camera and I'm not sure how to end it or what I should say to switch it to the next scene so that it's seamless. So I'll immediately have a thought, oh no, how do I end it? What do I do? What do I say? And then that thought will cause me to have a feeling of anxiety. And the book that I'm reading, The Wise Heart,
it talks about the Buddhist teaching of how we have primary feelings that will cause emotions from those primary feelings. And those primary feelings could be unpleasant or pleasant. And they can either be the parents of aversion, delusion, or happiness, joy, peace, and so on. So I'm now going to be even more aware of the thoughts that lead to my anxiousness because I was thinking about a feeling of anxiousness. And a feeling of anxiousness is when you don't trust because you think you have to know. So if I have a thought that leads me to have a feeling of anxiousness, all I have to do is allow my thought to be and choose to trust that it will play out the way that it should play out. And I think maybe it's because we want things to be a specific way. And if they don't end up a specific way, then we will have to readjust our expectations or our expected plan that we have. But at the end of the day, life's gonna do what life's gonna do. And you're either gonna be anxious about it, or you're gonna trust it and have fun with it. So I'm not even gonna be concerned with how I end these clips of me talking. I'm not even going to worry about what I'm saying, how long I'm talking. I'm letting it go, yo. I'm done. But seriously, you gotta choose to trust. You gotta choose to trust when you're anxious. When you're anxious, it's because you need to know what's going on, what's happening. Oh my gosh, I'm confused. Oh, you know, those are the feelings of like, oh my God. Just trust. Because it's gonna do what it's gonna do. Am I right or am I right? Leave me a comment down below if that hits you, if that hits home. Leave a comment down below if that hits home. Bars. I'm gonna start spitting bars. I'm gonna start flowing. I'm just gonna leave the camera running and see what comes out. Who knows? Who knows? So far, I'm enjoying. See, but this is the thing. If I don't know how to, where do I end it? Because I could keep this clip going for a long time. We could just be chilling. I don't mind. Is this the entire vlog today? Just this? Maybe. Maybe. No, I'm gonna end it. I'm gonna end it. All right. See, what am I gonna say? Till next time. Catch you later. Till the next clip. See you soon. See you later, alligator. All of the above. All of the above. Thank you.
fingers already hurt. But from what I remember, I think it's going to be about a week until they start to callus and they won't hurt anymore. This is now my third attempt at learning to play the guitar. But this time, once I go through this pain, I'm not doing it over again. No more. I am going to stick with it. Okay. I gotta be honest. I really want to shave. I really want to shave because I have never seen my underarm hair this long. I have so many moments where I catch a glimpse and I immediately want to shave it off so bad. But then I also have little slips in my consciousness where I look at it and I'm like, ooh, sexy. That's dope. I love it. So as you can tell, I'm kind of going back and forth with it. But I'm not going to shave it. I'm going to stay strong for now. But I am noticing that there are a lot of thoughts of getting rid of it. But it's funny because I was telling my friend that when I'm by myself, I love it. I kind of dig it. I think it's dope. But when I'm around other people, that's where my insecurities come out. But I was going to tweet something the other day, and I was going to say, if he doesn't want to lick my underarm hair, then I don't want him. Am I right? And then my friend said, if you can't accept me at my hairiest, you don't accept me at all. I'm just saying, it's spitting facts, and the only reason why I want to shave it is because women aren't supposed to have underarm hair. This is a dude thing. This is a straight up dude. Like, you don't think of a woman having this. That's why it's like, it's challenging every limiting belief that has been pounded into my head since childhood, that a woman should not have hair like this. But if we were in a society that says, yes, women are so beautiful, natural, that's so weird that you shave. Why would you shave? It's beautiful the way that you look, naturally. Well, then it would be complete opposite. So I think I need to do more of that. I think I need to reaffirm to myself of what societal norms are not reality and not fact and not truth. Because the truth is, women naturally are beautiful and fucking stunning and shouldn't have to change a thing. I should not look in the mirror and immediately be like, oh my God, I need to shave. I should just look at it and say it's hair. Because at the end of the day, that's what it is. It is hair, everyone. Hair. That's all I wanted to say. That was my 2 cents for the day. But I also had this idea where I want to commission an artist to paint me nude with my underarm hair and my bush. Because I think that's so sexy and so dope. So, just a little thought. Just a little thought that I had. So I think maybe it is a lifestyle and a mentality that I am growing into. It's like my higher self is pulling my lower frequency self, like, it's hair, who cares? Come on, it doesn't matter. What if someone painted you with your hair? Beautiful. It would be beautiful. It would be gorgeous. I would love that. But I got these low vibration thoughts
telling me that's a dude thing. Yo, your hair too long. Ooh. But that's not facts. That is not facts. And I just need to keep reminding my low vibrational self that it is not true. And I am beautiful as I am with all my hair.
I am having a salad for lunch. It's carrots with kale and sun-dried tomato. Cheers. It's good. But I want my hair. Not slick. I didn't really do my hair. I just took it out of the braid and the bun and yeah, that works. So, but if we're really being honest, the kind of love that I am manifesting, the kind of partner and relationship that I'm calling into my life, is not going to care about hair. And that partner is going to love me unconditionally, no matter what body hair I have, no matter what I look like in the morning, no matter if I get sick with cancer and lose all of the hair on my head and on my body, who I know would take care of me in a wheelchair and bathe me if I have to. That's the kind of love that we all deserve. A love that doesn't have conditions. A love that doesn't end at appearances. A love that is way more than skin deep. That sees your soul. No matter what you look like. And still loves you unconditionally. So that's really the real reason why I'm keeping it for this long. And also building and growing my own self-love unconditionally. Because I don't want to look at myself and not love myself just because I have hair on my body. And when you really talk about it, and when you really understand what it is, the facade of the societal norm of shaving is shattered. Because it has no fact behind it. I actually don't know the history of why women started shaving. I'm not sure if it has cultural reasons or spiritual purposes, but I know that in this Western society, it doesn't have a deeper meaning other than to look better. And I don't want to base any of my decisions off of what it looks like. So, even though I really do want to shave it, a part of me does, I'm keeping it because it is expanding and growing my self-love and calling in people that love me unconditionally. Yeah.
This morning, I wrote a short poem about love. it goes. The kind of love I imagine myself in is one where we dive deep to the depths within, swimming in the vast seas of one another when oceans collide, crash into each other.